What's going on? This is Dave Lozano. I am from New Haven, Connecticut. We're here at Brick House. We're going to be performing tonight for Laffaholics. I got a 15-minute set to pretty much show myself to the world. Looking forward to it. I bet you're going to see more of me.
All right, go ahead, DJ. Cut that off. Yeah, I told him to play something light-skinned, so I felt comfortable, first of all, just so you know. I'm going to let you guys know right now, in case you can't tell. I'm half white. Got real fucking quiet in here. And I'm half Puerto Rican. Oh, I hear a woo. The best thing about being half and half is I get to pick and choose which one I am depending on where I'm at. I don't know where the fuck to go with it tonight, I'm gonna be honest with you. Yeah, no, there's no short shot here. Just to be safe, let me test it out though. Puerto Ricans, make some noise. All right, six. I think I even added one to that. All right, white people, make some noise. Try to make up for that. I see what you're doing. All right, I don't want nobody feeling left out though. Black people, make some noise. Made you want to change and shit, right? I think I'm gonna be light skinned tonight. I think that's the safest fucking route to go. DJ, put the Drake back on. Let me feel. He like, hold on, wait, you asking me to play a song? This is crazy. Nah, it's good, it's right, it's all right, it's all right. The reason why I like Drake, though, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, if you listen to Drake, the reason why I like him is because he's bipolar. A lot of people don't understand what I'm saying, but listen, if you hear Drake in a song, he likes to sing and be emotional. And then on the next track, he's a gangster. But I feel like Drake is so smooth about it, though, he could get away with anything. Like, he could come home in the middle of his night, his girl be upset, and he could ask for a sandwich right in the middle of it, and play it off. You guys think I'm playing? Imagine Drake coming home in the middle of the night like this, just Drake does this, I don't know what it is, but it looked good when he do it. Drake, it's 3 a.m., where was you at? Listen, I'm not trying to argue. I just want a sandwich. Please just make me a sandwich. Please don't tell me no, 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 no. Oh. Don't tell me no. She'd be like, did you just sing? I'm gonna make you a sandwich because that was kind of cute. How you want the sandwich? That's when Drake goes bipolar right there, rap mode. Before you start it, from the bottom, put it on wheat bread with lettuce, tomato, but please hold the pickle. Don't act like you did not know that. I did not like the pickle, cause motherfucker, you know it. Like, oh! She feeling it too with the lettuce, tomato, the pickle, the what? What you said? I didn't hear what you said. This shit sounded good. Now, a lot of people in here right now who don't listen to hip hop is like, just wanna listen to it cause they rap about stupid stuff. But let's bring it back to an old school artist who I feel like was also bipolar that a lot of people didn't really pay attention to catch the signs. Michael Jackson. Now, I love Michael Jackson, but I feel like Michael, imagine coming to him like in the middle of the night, same situation. I feel like Mike would have did a little smoother. Mike coming home like this, just. You know, Mike breathed on everything and it sounded good. Mike, it's 3 a.m., where was you at? Before you say anything, I'm not trying to argue, but there'll be no fighting tonight up in this house. Oh no. See the foot? Like, Mike, I'm gonna make you a sandwich because that was kind of cute. How you want the sandwich? Mike will make a song out of it. When you make me a sandwich, stop with the lettuce and tomatoes. Not a one, no pickles. This from Mike will like go bipolar though right here. Mike, why you want no pickles? You told me that you like the pickles. So how come over? Anybody that could kick mid-sentence. You got nervous when I kicked. You was like, this motherfucker's shoe come off. I wish it would. Made me feel awkward. Scary, man. Nothing. I don't care. I'm from New Haven. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. Have you ever heard a noise in the middle of the night when you're by yourself? I don't care how tough you think you are, that's when your punk side comes out. All right? So you at home, right? I got a bed at my house, but for the sake of the stage, you watching TV and you hear a noise, I feel like this is how everybody reacts. The first time you hear it, you convince yourself that you didn't hear it because you had a long day. You're really not trying to get up. But if you hear it again, everything changes. You got to be more serious. You know, when you turn the volume down, at this point you become a detective in your own house. And you gotta get up like real sneakily. Let's time out for a second. I heard the first row. Repeat the fucking word. Is that not a word? Sneakily. Who? Raise your hand if you had a problem with sneakily. Well, goddamn, man, you ain't gotta do a group effort. It's like to sneak in a Lee manner. You knew what the fuck I was trying to say. Yeah, I was too confident with that. You get up quietly. Is that better? Shit, New Haven ain't never questioned that. And when you get up, it don't matter who you are. We all say one word. This is it. We all say it's one thing. This is it. Hello? What the hell is hello? Can somebody break down hello for me, please? Because if somebody say something, what do you say back to that? Hello? Yeah. If you could say, yeah, in my house, you could take whatever the fuck you want. Just stay downstairs. And do it sneakily, bitch. Repeat the word again, I swear to God. Tired of them motherfuckers. Kids, clap it up if you got kids. I'm curious to see how many, a lot of babysitters right now wondering where the hell y'all at. Here's the thing, I'm Puerto Rican. I'm 31 years old, and I have one kid. No good, that's a standing ovation. I don't think y'all realize I'm a fucking prize in New Haven. That's right. But the thing is, I feel like we all raise our kids the same. I asked my son the other day, I said, Evan, we got bills now, you know, you ate. This is a good question to ask. I want to see where his mind was. I said, what do you want to be when you grow up? And he looked at me, serious face. He goes, Poppy, when I grow up, I want to be a magician. Now, I had a couple problems with that. Because number one, I said, Evan, we have bills. But what the fuck was this? He looked at me, goes, oh, Poppy, I want to be a magician because I want to make things disappear. I didn't get that. I looked at him, I was like, come here. We're Puerto Rican, we already make things disappear. This is what the fuck we do, okay? So I said, you know what, I'm gonna be a good dad and I want to help him commit his first crime. Don't make the faces, all right? I did it sneakily. We was at Dunkin' Donuts, right? He just wanted a donut. I was like, all right, you know what? We walked in, and then he goes, oh, Poppy, can I get a Gatorade too? I'm like, really wanted to spend a dollar, but all right. Just sit down, don't touch nothing else. She's like, I can help you over here. I was like, yeah, I just want to get a chocolate frosted donut, that's all. Oh my God, is that all you're waiting for? I said, yeah, can we hurry it up? So she's like, hold on, honey. There you go, you're all set. How much is it? Don't worry about it, I'm not making you pay for that. Get out of here. Okay, you sure?
Yeah.
All right, Evan, let's go. Poppy, what about the Gatorade? Shut the fuck up, you just became a magician. Have a good day. You too. See somebody do that shit, just check your pockets, that's all. It's crazy, man. You know, I'm gonna be honest with you, being half Puerto Rican, you know, I pick and choose all the time. Sometimes I go to a Spanish club and they don't really have, like, it's just always Spanish music. And if you don't know how to dance it, you look kind of stupid. So I'm like, I gotta learn how to do it. So I learned how to look like I'm Spanish dancing. And I'm gonna teach y'all this, so in case after the show you wanna try it out, you don't know how to do it, six white people, I see you. You can check it. So here's what you gotta do, is a couple steps. Step number one, you put one hand on your stomach like you're hungry. Okay? Step two, you put one hand in the air like somebody just let you over in traffic and you'll appreciate it. Step three, this is very important. You have to make a face like you just tasted something and you don't like it. Step four, you look at your feet from time to time. And step five, when you see somebody in the club that you happen to know, you point at them. Y'all don't believe me, do you? DJ, I'm gonna give you a job to play a song, if that's okay. Give me the... Now start from the beginning, let's do it. Just start that shit from the very beginning. I know y'all know this shit. Watch how this works. Cut the shit off. I'm not saying it's right. Just blend into Belish is what I'm trying to say. Dang, man, comedy is fun, but I'm gonna be honest with you. Sometimes when we be doing shows, there won't be a big budget. You know, comics won't be making a lot of money. And, you know, after the show, sometimes I want to get something to eat. I don't know about y'all, but when I don't got a lot of money, I keep it short. I go to McDonald's or something. You ever notice when you go to McDonald's, if it's not you, you don't got to say it. But me, I order off of one menu. Thank you, appreciate that. Because I know a lot of people in here don't know the other menu. Now, you ever notice when you order off the dollar menu, you say dollar every single time because it's always some new chick that just started? Welcome to McDonald's. Yeah, how you doing? Let me get a dollar Sprite. Let me get a dollar double cheeseburger. You watch it ring up to make sure it's tallying what you were supposed to say. Let me get a dollar fry. You put the regular fry. I said the dollar fry. It's supposed to be $3.18. I know what's supposed to happen here. No, you're going to have to fix that. Get the manager. That's fine. So I started thinking, imagine if some of the comics that I grew up watching used to hang out and go to McDonald's together after the show too. Imagine if Chris Tucker, one of my favorites, Bernie Mac, rest in peace, and Cat Williams. Imagine if all three of them went to McDonald's and the person working at the cash register was Kevin Hart. I'm gonna play this out. This is how I feel like that might sound. Chris Tucker.
God damn, man, what kind of shit is this, man? Hey, man, it's Friday, we ain't got shit to do. Man, I gotta go to McDonald's to get fucked up, man. Just follow my lead when you get in here, man. Hey, little man, is you working, man? You see, we hungry.
Kevin Hart. Huh? What you say? First of all, here's the fucking thing. My name is Kevin. Welcome to McDonald's. Just about to get real. All right. It's my first day on the job. Don't make me laugh.
Hey, man, ain't nobody here to make you laugh, man. Anyways, let me get a dollar Sprite. Let me get a dollar Nugget.
I gotta tell you something, you're not gonna like it. The manager took the Nugget off the dollar menu the other day. Said it's not there anymore. I was like, no. They wasn't ready. No.
What kind of shit is this, man? Hey, man, Bernie, we had to come up with a solution, man.
Chris, I'm a fucking tell us home straight fucking now. You motherfuckers high on my motherfucking ear for. I got a simple fucking solution. All we gotta do is get a fucking 20 piece and divide it between all fucking three of us.
I ain't thinking of shit, man.
Kevin, that's your fucking name? Ring the motherfucker up. Huh? First of all, you ain't gonna talk to me like I'm a bitch, cause I'm not a bitch, cause it's me. I run it all day by myself. One motherfucking register. Ready to go, night night?
Man, who the hell is he yelling at, man?
First of all, I just said you're getting loud. I don't like the way you're getting loud. The reason why you're getting too loud, because I don't like it. First of all, you need to come up with a solution. First of all, you need to know menu, okay?
What the hell is he saying, man? Do you understand the words that are coming out of our mouth, man? Man, let's just ask Cat if he's cool with that shit and get the hell up out of here, man. Mm. a pimp, but I may not be a mathematician, but I can tell you something right now. Wait for it. The 20 nuggets between three people ain't gonna split evenly, motherfucker. Someone gonna get seven, someone gonna get seven, someone gonna get six. This shit right here, this shit right here, this shit right here, this shit right motherfucker here. Someone better come up with another solution. I'm sorry, I'll wait.
Guys, my name is Dave Lozano. Thank you so much. I appreciate y'all. Keep it going for Raiders, y'all.